If you wanted to create a reality TV franchise about fairy tale romance, be honest, would it actually look like The Bachelor? Would it begin at a rose-covered mansion, with a creepily smug host greeting limos full of ball-gown-clad ladies as they stepped onto slickened pavement to meet their dream man? Would it be designed around an iconography of roses, an elaborate ritual of hometown dates, and fantasy suites? Would there be so much pressure on proposals and marriage that a doofus who can't make up his mind ends up displaying someone's naked pain on a breakup split screen? Probably not. Although The Bachelor is a vision of love conceived in 2002, odds are the franchise will stay exactly as it is until everyone stops watching, at which point, Chris Harrison will get entombed in the Bachelor mansion like a rose-themed cask of Immortal Auto. But after Bachelor in Paradise and the last season of The Bachelorette aimed for relevance and suffered serious missteps, and now that Aries' disastrous season is almost behind us, it's a good time to consider alternatives for the long-term future of the franchise. Here are 7 ideas that could save The Bachelor from itself, from overdue changes to radical reinventions. Oh, and ABC? Feel free to institute these before The Bachelor returns. Anything but another season like Aries. At the end of the season, the farthest a bachelor or bachelorette can go is, should we maybe think about moving in together when my lease ends? This is the most immediate and obvious need. The cast should always be significantly more diverse than your familiar 3 white Lawrence and 2 white Becca's model. There should be many people of color from a variety of backgrounds. There should be seasons where most of the cast is queer. There should be a season where all of the cast is over 35. There should be a season where the lead has a disability, and that season should include at least one mea culpa for the horrible way the series edited Sarah Harron. There should be trans people and non-binary people. There should be a season of all military vets. There should also be a season of all librarians, just because. Think real world mixed with the uncanny congeniality of the Great British Bake Off. Rather than cast contestants nationally, The Bachelor would get local, with each season set in a different city where the contestants, and the lead, all within, say, a 50-mile radius. Not only would this recast some of the awkward endgame strategy, so, could you ever imagine yourself moving to the middle of nowhere in Iowa? It'd also give contestants more points of shared reference, and it'd give each season a distinct vibe. The contestants wouldn't even stay in a mansion the whole time. Like Bake Off, they'd get to go home in their usual s while also competing in the reality show. They'd consult with their friends, which would happen on camera, of course. They'd be allowed to use the internet. They could go on all those bonkers group dates during a weekend of filming, but afterward, they could go home and spend a week obsessing over how producers will edit their narratives. It'd all be a welcome change from the usual Bachelor Mansion drama. Repeat after me. Ladies, this is the final block of cave-age cheddar of the night. Or, for the lactose intolerant, a few alternatives. Final sheet mask of the night. Final bag of donuts from that place you like of the night. Final advance copy of the new N.K. Jemisin book of the night. Final pair of very comfy slippers of the night. The Bachelor. But it's a crossover with Fixer Upper. Everyone works in the real estate industry and they all renovate the mansion while dating The Bachelor. The Bachelor. But it's a crossover with Survivor. The contestants get to vote each other out and no one has easy access to food or showers. Or even better, The Bachelor, but it's actually just Terrace House. Sure, none of those will happen because they're not all on ABC, but I'm sure there's some version of The Bachelor Shark Tank we could figure out. Ditch the mansion, force Chris Harrison to take up a position of host emeritus, and start again with a Bachelor that has a whole new look and feel. If you walked into the new Bachelor mansion and it looked more like a cozy, sprawling upstate New York farmhouse, with a Nancy Myers kitchen and 17 fireplaces and original hardwood floors. Hosted by Queer Eye's Garamo, the rebooted Bachelor would have lots of wine and occasionally some formal wear, and hot tubs, of course. But rather than bizarre world group dates, Garamo would invite everyone to low-key daytime hangs where they get to know one another in a more grounded setting. I'm talking cooking classes, trips to a dog park, food truck festivals. But do not tell me daytime events make for bad television. If Real Housewives can do it, so can The Bachelor. A guest appearance on The Bachelorette's Friends podcast, attend a protest karaoke, attend an awkward industry awards banquet for The Bachelor's work canvas for a local politician UPS failed to dare a package. So who can get to the shipping facility first? Trivia night trip to the Apple store to get a contestant's laptop keyboard replaced. Attend a contestant's cousin's wedding. When you're thinking back on the dullness of this Bachelor season or casting your memory over the many identical formal wear clad contestants of the franchise's past, remember that it doesn't have to be this way. We could imagine a different vision of a reality TV romance fairy tale. We could say no, thank you to the roses, and we could turn our collective faces towards a season of The Bachelorette where host Busy Phillips announces, "Gentlemen, this is the last phone charging cable of the night. I just really wanted to get that last phone charger." The men would say sadly, as they took an Uber back to their apartments at the end of the elimination ceremony, "My dog really liked her. Plus, I needed a new phone charger. The Bachelor is broken, so here are 7 ways to fix it."